हेलो, गुड इवनिंग आन्या दीदी, वेलकम बैक। एंड वेरी इम्पोर्टेंट क्वेश्चंस आर कमिंग ऑन द टॉपिक ऑफ व्हाई डू वी फॉल इल। वेरी वेरी इम्पोर्टेंट क्वेश्चंस, सो वी लाइक टू सॉल्व देम क्वेश्चंस एंड पार्टिसिपेट इन द क्वेश्चन सेशंस। यू सी दैट वी हैव टोल्ड यू व्हाट टाइप ऑफ डिसीजेस वी आर, एंड acute diseases, chronic diseases, infectious diseases, non-infectious diseases, then the infectious agents, protozoans, pathogens, viruses, bacteria, and which diseases are infectious diseases, and what are the principles of prevention of the diseases, or what how to treat the diseases, principles of treatment and prevention of the diseases. All this we did it. Yes, we have done. Sure. Anya, we did all this with you. Tell me. So the first question before us is coming. What is the first question? As you can see, first question is, which one of the following is not a viral disease? Which one of the following is not a viral disease? The question is before us. What is the answer of the first question? This question. First question. What is the answer of this? Which one of the following is not a viral disease? You are given four choices: dengue, AIDS, typhoid, influenza. Which is not a viral disease? What is the correct answer for this? What is the correct answer for the first question? Which is not a viral disease out of the four? What is the correct answer?
Typhoid.
Tell me, what is the correct answer? Which one of the following is not a viral disease? What is the correct?
Typhoid. Typhoid.
Typhoid is the correct answer. Correct answer. You are getting one full mark. Is absolutely right. Typhoid is caused by what? It is caused by a. What is the cause of the typhoid? You know. What is that? There is a bacteria.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Question number two. We are coming. Which one of the following is not a bacterial disease? Which of the following is not a bacterial disease? You are given four choices: cholera, tuberculosis, anthrax, influenza. Which is the correct answer for this?
Sir, influenza.
Correct answer. That is a right answer given by Anya. You give the correct answer, getting another mark. And the third question before you. Which one of the following diseases is not transmitted by the mosquito? Mosquito, you know that mosquito is very, very dangerous for us. And how many deaths have been?
Typhoid.
Typhoid, brain fever is caused by the mosquito. Malaria is caused by the mosquito. Dengue is caused by the typhoid. Is the correct answer. You are getting another mark. Absolutely right answer given by Anya. Next question before you, Anya. Which one of the following diseases is caused by bacteria? You have four choices: students, typhoid, anthrax, tuberculosis, malaria. Which one of the following diseases is caused by the bacteria?
Some malaria is caused by bacteria.
Huh? Which one of the following is caused by bacteria? What is the bacteria? Which one is caused by the bacteria? Which one you answered?
Some malaria.
Malaria is caused by the bacteria, or there is something else what they call as parasite. Parasite. What about typhoid? Typhoid is caused by what? Check it out. Check it out. How is the typhoid? How
Yes,
is
sir.
it? Huh?
Typhoid.
Typhoid. So the correct answer was typhoid. this is the wrong answer. So this is the correct choice. So you are getting. Now the next question: which one of the following diseases is caused by protozoans? Which one of the following is caused by protozoans?
Some malaria is caused by protozoans.
Yes, that is the thing. Malaria is caused by the protozoans. That was the answer for the malaria. Protozoans. Protozoans are caused, responsible for the malaria. It is the correct answer given by Anya. Next question. Classify the following disease as infectious or non-infectious. Classify the following as infectious or non-infectious diseases. You have how many choices are there for you? You have classify the following as infectious or non-infectious diseases. A part is AIDS. AIDS is infectious or non-infectious?
Sir, AIDS is infectious.
Correct answer. AIDS is infectious. These questions are very important for your papers. Infectious. What about tuberculosis?
Sir, it is also infectious.
Tuberculosis is infectious. What about cholera?
Sir, it is also infectious.
Infectious. Okay, correct answer. Correct answer. What about high blood pressure?
Sir, non-infectious.
Non-infectious. Non-infectious. Okay, what is heart disease?
Sir, it is non-infectious.
Non-infectious.
Pneumonia. Sir, pneumonia is infectious and cancer is non-infectious.
Infectious and cancer is non-infectious. All the answers given by Anya, absolutely correct answer given by you. All the answers correct. How many? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So 7 correct answers have been given by you. Excellent performance. Further, we are coming to, this is our question 1. This is our 3, question 4, question 5, question 6. In 6, you have so many parts. And question number 8. Name the disease that can be caused by UV radiations. You know, UV radiations are very harmful to the us if they will reach us. What is the disease which would be caused by the...
So skin cancer is caused by UV radiation.
Correct answer. Correct answer given by Anya. Such a good answer. Oh my God. You know so much about that. Mm-hmm. Cancer will be caused by this is the correct answer. Question number 9. Why does it intake of penicillin not affect human cells? You know, penicillin is used as an antibiotic. Antibiotics. So what the antibiotics do? What the antibiotics do? Antibiotics are effective where? How does the antibiotics work? Anya, you know about it. How does antibiotics work? This is a very important question. Very important question. How the antibiotics, penicillin is the simplest antibiotic and it works. And now we have broad spectrum antibiotics which are having bigger range and they kill different types of bacteria.
So penicillin does not affect human cells because penicillin does not inhibit any biochemical process that goes on within us.
And how does it affect the bacteria? The main thing is about penicillin. What? How penicillin is? How the penicillin helps in killing the bacteria? How penicillin acts as an antibiotic? What is the thing? What the bacteria? What penicillin stops in bacteria? See, if you have a bacteria in the body, the bacteria does what? How the penicillin kills the bacteria? How the bacteria dies when you take penicillin? Penicillin is an antibiotic. Anya, what is that which it stops? This is a very important question. Very important question. Very, your answer is not wrong, but here some information is there which is very important. That question will be asked in your papers. That question will be asked in your paper. That how does
penicillin prevents the bacteria from reforming a new cell wall?
May the actually bacteria for survival form their cell, the cell walls. Bacteria forms their cell wall. So this penicillin will stop the formation of cell wall of the bacteria. So it does not allow the bacteria to make their cell wall. Therefore, they will not be existing. Then they will start dying. Therefore, they will be killed. And in our cells, we are not building cell walls. And therefore, penicillin does not affect human. That is why if penicillin would affect human cells also, then we can't use it. Then we can't use it. That is very clear. Now, very important question. Very important question. So we should be aware of when we answer question, what is the question? The immediate causes of many diseases are not infectious. The immediate causes of many diseases are not infectious. Name one organ each affected by. The immediate causes of many diseases are not infectious. Can you give examples? Are not infectious. Give the examples. You have to give examples. Give examples of non-infectious diseases. Give examples of non-infectious diseases.
So heart disease, cancer.
Yes, cancer, diabetes, and all those. Cancer, diabetes. These are not examples of the infectious disease. Name one organ affected by malaria. Name one organ.
Sir, malaria primarily affects the liver.
Liver is the correct answer. Then RBC. And also it can affect the spleen. Tuberculosis, name one organ affected by the tuberculosis.
Sir, it affects the lungs.
Correct answer. Lungs, you know, very, very dangerous. This is also the correct answer. Correct answer. Question number 12. One and one. Okay, question number 13. Why do female mosquitoes need highly nutritious food in the form of human blood? You know that in the mosquito, the one which is most dangerous is the female mosquitoes. What do? They suck your blood. Why do they need blood? Very important. Because not all the mosquitoes are dangerous, even so many mosquitoes are there. But these female
mosquitoes need highly nutritious food in the form of human blood because they use the protein and iron from human blood to lay eggs.
Very good. Absolutely correct answer. This question will be asked in your paper also. Very important question. Very, very important question. When they have to lay eggs, they need nutritive food. So they'll take human blood. Or blood from animals. Which organ is affected if person is suffering from jaundice? Jaundice, if you are suffering.
Sir, liver.
Liver is the correct answer. Which organ is named the, which organ is affected? Jaundice, liver. Is the correct answer. What are vectors?
Sir, the animals carrying the infecting agents from a sick person to another potential host are known as vectors.
Okay, correct. You know what happens? There are organisms which spread pathogens from infected person to healthy person. Examples? What are the examples of vector?
Some mosquitoes.
Female mosquitoes is what it is doing. Sand fly. Female mosquito. They are raptors. Correct answer. Correct answer. We have female. Female mosquito. They are female mosquito. Is we should be very careful of that. Female mosquitoes. And they usually attack in the dark. You see them in the morning, you don't see them. No, in the dark places, you will see them. Then, in many species of mosquito, the males do not prefer blood, but females to state why. I think answered the question already. This important question, important, we are asking again. It's not the male species, the females which are needy, which are preferring the blood because they have to lay the eggs, you are saying. So that is the correct answer. Okay. Write any biochemical pathway in bacteria that is blocked by the antibiotics like bacteria. Antibiotics you take for bacteria. Penicillin kills the bacteria. So what it blocks when you take penicillin, what it is doing, what it blocks, students, what it blocks. The biochemical pathway. There is a biochemical pathway that you have to stop. If it is stopped, then it will die. And in penicillin, what it does? It stops.
Sir, it blocks the cell wall synthesis.
Yes, correct answer. The cell walls will be blocked. It blocks the cell walls. Very important question, cell walls. The cell walls of the bacteria is blocked and therefore bacteria will die. Now we have started understanding how the drugs are working, how the drugs are working. You see that what type of diseases are there and what methods we are using for prevention or what type of treatments we are giving, how everything is acting. Another question is coming, right? Any viral that we have done it, then why is it difficult to make antiviral drugs? Is a very important question. Why it is difficult to make antiviral drugs? You know, coronavirus is a viral drug. Viral is a virus. It's a virus, and you have not been able to make any drug to kill. So it is difficult to kill viruses. It's very difficult to kill viruses. That means it is so difficult. What is the reason? What the drugs are doing? What the penicillin is doing in bacteria? It is stopping its biochemical pathway. If something doesn't have its own biochemical pathway, then what will we do? That is the problem. So what you are answering for this?
Sir, it is difficult to make antiviral drug because viruses have very few biochemical mechanisms of their own, and they use our host cells to replicate.
Excellent answer. Most important question of the day. This is the reason that you have seen coronavirus is we are not able to get a drug medicine till date for the coronavirus, because it's a virus, so killing a virus is not possible by antibiotics, or antibiotics are not working. And how will, because the pathway bio, they have very few pathways of their own, and that makes it so difficult. Virus is not going. That is the reason that now the news is that according to the MCD, it is expected in the winter more than 15,000 cases will be there per day. So it is going to increase during winter season. So that means that this infection is spreading and we don't have any medicine, anything for that. Only prevention is better than cure. What are you doing? Okay, next we are coming to 17th question. What it says, What causes encephalitis? How does it enter the body? Which organ does it infect? What are the symptoms if this organ is infected? Very, very important question. What is this? Encephalitis is a very dangerous disease caused by what? Very, very important. Very, very important. It is caused by what?
Sir, the most common cause of encephalitis is virus.
You know which virus it is? JEV. What they call JEV? What is JEV? JEV. Japanese encephalitis entrance. So how does it enter the body? Bite of a? How does it enter the body?
Sir, it can enter through the bite of a mosquito.
Mainly, you know that is a female Culex. Mosquito like female, and they infect the brain. What it does? The bite of the female mosquito. I was not knowing earlier, but mosquito is actually responsible for large number of these life-threatening diseases. It's a female mosquito is very dangerous. And this will suck the blood, and what happens to the brain? It affects your brain. It's all called brain fever.
Yes, sir.
Brain fever. It's very dangerous. Brain fever. What are the symptoms? There will be inflammation of brain and membrane, severe rigors, altered mental status, seizures, severe headaches.
Sir, you can also have fever or headaches or no symptoms at all.
And severe headaches, stiff neck or... Now the most important thing about this is there any vaccine available for this? You are getting 3 marks here. There is a vaccine available for it. Very interesting. Vaccine available. They are available to make the vaccine for this is available. Okay, coming to the next question. Very, very important questions. Which one of the following disease will cause major ill effects of general health? General health. You have cold, tuberculosis, disease will cause major ill effects. What do you mean by major ill effects? What? Major ill effects means what? When I'm saying major ill effects.
Sir, elephantiasis and tuberculosis will cause major ill effect on health.
Why?
Sir, because these diseases are chronic diseases and they last long.
Very good answer given by you. Chronic diseases are more dangerous than acute. If a disease is chronic, then it will not last. It will go through for a longer period of time. And in clinical cases, you know that critical cases, chronic, they could cause even death. So tuberculosis and encephalitis is the correct answer. Major ill effects. So those diseases which you are talking about are chronic diseases. Chronic disease. I told you there are two types of diseases, acute and chronic. So chronic is more dangerous than acute. And acute diseases, can you give example of acute diseases? Examples of the acute diseases? acute disease last for
cough and cold are acute diseases.
You are the viral fevers you are having or typhoid fever. This will go after some period of time. Bone fracture, we told you, they are healing over a period of time. So, okay, we have been able to answer these questions. We are coming to the next question. Name two bacterial diseases that spread through contaminated water. Contaminated water is a serious source of diseases. You know about it. So contaminated water, polluted water, drainage water goes into the water you are drinking. It will cause serious disease. Which diseases are these?
Sir, cholera and typhoid.
Correct answer given by Anya. Cholera and typhoid is an absolutely right answer. Okay, you're getting one more mark here. Now, coming to the next question. Apart from sexual contact, AIDS virus can spread by which other means? See, AIDS is a very dangerous disease and is infectious. Then the main cause was sexual contact. But how further it can go? What other thing is there? How it can spread?
Sir, it can spread from blood to blood contact with infected people. Or it can also spread from infected mother to her baby.
Yes, blood transfusion you are saying. That is called blood transfusion. What is that? Blood transfusion. So when you give blood of one person to other, if it is infected, then what will happen? This will be, the AIDS will go. Then contaminated syringes. Contaminated syringes and needles. You know that vaccine time, the syringes are being used, it should be disposable. They should be disposable. If they are using contaminated, what will happen? Then it can enter into the person. And you have seen tattooing. The people are having tattoos in their bodies. You see that?
Yes, sir.
But people are liking it. It is so hard and difficult. What they are doing, they are doing some needle, using a needle for something. It's a very, is it painful? I don't know anything about that. But it could cause a serious infections. Very serious infections can be caused. Some people are doing it. But these are the, any syringes, etc. you are touching to your body and in the blood, you know, it's going to be dangerous. So contaminated needles, syringes, tattooing, all this can go. For this, that answer is also correct. Next, list the causative organisms for AIDS.
Sir, AIDS is caused by HIV, which is which full form is a human immunodeficiency virus.
Human immunodeficiency virus. Human immunity is finished. We told you on this. Once immunity is damaged, then what happens? Then from minor infections, body cannot survive. And then it can cause death. So human immunodeficiency virus is the correct answer. Correct answer. And name two fungal diseases.
Sir, aspergillosis and candida auris are two fungal diseases.
Yes, that ringworm. Also is that athletes put, they say barbs. So all the correct answers have been given. Unbelievable. How many marks you are getting? 1, 2, 3, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29. So you're getting 29 out of 30. So it's a great performance. Great. That you could answer all the questions correctly. Unbelievable. Unbelievable. All these are important questions. Important questions. Okay. Okay. Let's see something more. Some more interesting things. Okay. More interesting things are coming. These are all the questions which we are expecting in your paper, students. In your papers, we are expecting in your papers all these types of questions. As you can see that in your book, they are talking about ki state any two conditions essential for good health. You already know that conditions for good health.
So good economic condition and social environment.
Correct answer. Next question. State any two conditions essential for being free of disease.
So living in a hygienic environment and getting vaccination against infectious diseases.
Correct answer. This is also one. What are infectious diseases? Right, two ways by which they can be controlled. What are infectious diseases? Diseases which are These diseases are caused by
where microbes and immediate causes are called infectious diseases.
Pathogens or organisms, microorganisms are spreading this. What do you call them as? Pathogens.
Yes, sir.
Pathogens. How you can control them? Two ways to control them. What are the two ways they are treated? One is what you treat in this? Treatment of what you are doing. Either you will treat the symptoms or you will kill the infectious agents. Either you will kill the pathogens or you will see the symptomatic.
So we should get vaccinated and we should not share our personal items.
Okay. Already you are living in quarantine isolation, all of you. You, me, everyone, we are all living in isolation already because of the infectious disease of coronavirus. So you are aware of that. Community health is essential for good individual health. Justify the statement by giving examples. So if in the community something goes wrong, then it will be infecting many people, not one. So what are those things, what you are going, those things like, what is the problem, where it is coming? In your community, what? What you are doing to have good health for community and yourself? Is there a proper removal of the garbage? Drainage is proper. Proper drinking water is there. And you are having mosquito sprays or all that sprays to kill them. Then do you have vaccination services in the government dispensaries, they are giving vaccines to the people. All these are examples. And unadulterated food and healthy and social interaction between the members of the community. All this, correct? Okay. List any two ways of preventing the spread of airborne diseases. How will you stop the spread of airborne diseases? How will you prevent the spread of airborne diseases? What will you do? To stop?
Sir, we should avoid close contact with people who have active symptoms of disease. Stay yes. home when you are sick. And if you are near someone who is sick, we should wear a face mask.
Yes, mask. Mask is now mandatory. You know that if I go without mask, there will be action against me. You know that mask is mandatory. We cannot go without mask anywhere. So even while you are in the car, if you don't have a mask, they will put a penalty on you. Mask is mandatory. So we are avoiding crowded places, crowded contacts. All this is important. Correct. Chances of spreading cholera are higher in village. Why? Why will the cholera spread higher in the village? What is the problem in the villages? People in the village are more prone to cholera diseases. What is the problem? Because what is not correct there? Yeah.
Sir, because water is not clean.
And you are saying contaminated water.
Sir, overcrowding and poor sanitation.
Food and all that. All right. That is the correct answer given by Anya. Correct answer. AIDS is a fatal disease. Explain why. This is an important question. Again, a very important question. I told you about something is there about AIDS. AIDS is a infectious fatal disease. AIDS is a fatal disease, and you have to explain why, student. What is the problem with the AIDS? We just talked of AIDS in a question. It is caused by what? AIDS was caused by?
Sir, AIDS is caused by HIV. It is a fatal disease because immune system of the body gets highly weakened and the body suffers from severe infection repeatedly.
Yes. And the result of this means that your human immune system is becoming extremely weak. Small infections will convert them. A cold will become pneumonia. Diarrhea and minor infections will cause diarrhea, blood loss, and then it can kill the patient. It can kill the patient. The immune system doesn't exist. It is destroyed. So it cannot save yourself from small and minor infections. And these minor infections will become big infections, and then ultimately it will cause the death. Influenza and or common colds are spreads faster and is difficult to control. Explain. Very important question. Very important question. Influenza and common cold. Influenza or common cold spread faster and is difficult to control. Anya, what is the answer for this?
Sir, influenza or common cold is an airborne disease. such disease causing microbes spread easily through air and are also infectious, which makes it difficult to control.
Yes. So what you are saying, influenza and common cold, they spread through droplets. What they call as, there are droplets. Droplets in air. The common cold. And what will happen? It will be highly infectious. One person can give it to large number of persons. And why it is difficult to control?
Sir, it is infectious and spreads through air.
Because antibiotics are not going to work. Very important. Antibiotics do not work. Do not work here. Are ineffective. What you are doing for other? You are taking antibiotics. But antibiotics you can take. But virus, it is virus. So therefore, it virus is not going to be killed by the viral disease. It is a viral disease, you are saying. It is a viral disease. Hence, virus cannot be killed by antibiotics. Therefore, treatment is difficult. Got it? Treatment is difficult. This is a very important question for you. All these. Okay, a few more questions are there. List three reasons why you would think that you are sick and ought to see a doctor. Do you feel like seeing a doctor? Why you want to see a doctor? Tell me. What is that? What symptoms you are going to experience? If you want to go to a doctor. What symptoms are you going to experience? Why do you want, when you will say, okay, let us go and visit a doctor. Under what conditions?
The symptoms can be cough, fever, or headache.
Okay, correct answer. In which of the following cases do you think the long-term effects in your health are likely to be the most? Get a jaundice, if you get lice, if you get acne, why?
Sir, the effects of jaundice will be long-term and most unpleasant because it is a chronic disease and it impacts the whole body and takes longer time to be cured completely.
Correct answer. Why are we normally advised to take bland and nourished food when we are sick?
So we are normally advised to take bland and nourishing food because it is easily digestible and contains all the nutrients, and it also gives nutrients and helps the body to get cured fast.
Correct answer given by Anya. Correct answer. What are different means by which infectious diseases are spread?
Sir, it can spread through air and it can also spread through direct or indirect contact with a sick person.
Correct answer.
It can also spread through contaminated food and water.
Correct answer. Anya, your knowledge is very good about this chapter. You have read it so well. Why do we fall sick? You know everything now. There's nothing left. All the questions also you've been able to answer. What precautions can you take in your school or reduce incidence of infectious diseases?
Sir, drinking clean and hygienic water prevention of accumulation of water in surroundings and keeping the toilet neat and clean.
Correct answer given by Anya. The last question is the most important and coming. What is immunization? And this question will be asked in your paper. What is immunization? Immunization, you know, it is something very interesting about it. That you are saying that some disease is coming, infectious disease is coming, that people will become immune. Immunization, what is immunization?
So immunization is a process in which an organism is made immune to fight against the disease-causing pathogen. It is done by the use of vaccines.
Yes, you know what happened actually. Smallpox was a very, very infectious disease. Smallpox, it spread. But as you have seen, here is a story of English physician named Edward Jenner realized that milkmaids who had cowpox did not catch smallpox. Actually, what is happening? Smallpox was spreading and people were being killed by smallpox, a very highly infectious disease. But he found there is another disease which is coming from cow. Those milkmaids, those people who are milking the cows, they were suffering from something like cowpox. And he found that those who are suffering from cowpox, they do not get chicken. They are not getting this disease. So cowpox, people who are suffering from cowpox have become immune of the smallpox. They are not getting smallpox. So what he started? He started giving cowpox to people. As you can see that, what is this doctor doing? He is giving cowpox to this. So what he feels, once it gets a cowpox, which is a mild disease, then it will become resistant to smallpox. So this was because a smallpox virus is closely related to cowpox virus. Cow in Latin, and cowpox is vaccinia. Cowpox is vaccinia. So from here they got vaccines. This vaccine's name has come from cowpox. Cow is called vacca in Latin. Latin cow means vacca. Vacca. So what they gave cowpox to the people so that they will not be infected by the smallpox. So that is what they call as, from that name came the vaccination, which you are talking about, that vaccines can, if we are vaccinated, then we will be able to protect ourselves. And this is called immunization. This is called immunization from the infectious disease which can come. And we have not been able to make any vaccine to date for the coronavirus. As they are saying, vaccine will come. Nobody knows when it will come. So that will give immunization. And you know, in our country, you know, what are the immunization programs available in nearest health center? You know, in your health centers, they are providing free vaccines to newborn children also. What type of vaccines? You know, which disease has been eradicated by vaccination in your country? Can you name that disease? All over the world, it has been eradicated by vaccine. Newborn children are also given those vaccines. You know about that? Do you remember anything about that? Are you aware of anything like that? Polio, you know polio vaccines? Polio droplets are also given now, polio.
Yes.
How many vaccines are given to the newborn children to make them immune from the diseases? How many marks did you get here then? These are also correct answers. How much we are getting? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, and here. So 16 out of 16. What was the previous score? You are getting 29 plus 16 out of 30 plus 16. You are getting 45 out of 46. So that is a great performance. You could answer most of the question. Great, great result. And congratulations to you. Congratulations to you, Anya. Your performance is very good. Well done. Well done. And all right, by this, the chapter is also finished. We've been able to solve all the questions. What next chapter we are going to begin?
In school, we are doing atoms and molecules, but we have already completed it.
Okay. Anyway, we'll see what other chapter is there. We would like to see what is the most important chapter. Then we will see, or we may first take some question answer sessions on atoms, because that will be coming in your paper. So, all right. Bye bye. We will see you in our next class. And I congratulate you, Anya, for such a great result which you gave. Answered all the questions on why do we fall sick, and questions were quite not that easy, because this is the first time you are answering all these questions about why do we fall sick, and that will help us in living a healthy life. And you can transmit this message to your parents and others, because here we have great knowledge of the spread of the prevention of the diseases. What are the principles? This is giving a complete knowledge of what diseases are, how they are spreading, and what are the methods to treat the diseases and prevent the disease. Okay, then. Bye-bye.
Thank you, sir.
Okay.